Why do women, ladies, cry when a man is proposing? Why the tears? Why are you shedding tears? Why do you cover your mouth and you begin to do I'm a lady and I am also married, so I don't understand it. Why this? And like, you followed him to the hotel, to that corner. You followed him and you saw that he gathered one or two or three people, even if it's a surprise, even if you never knew. Were you not thinking of marriage? The way your discussions were going, you know, this is why a lot of times those who are engaged or those who are planning to get married don't actually talk about their vision. They talk about, how was the food? Did you sleep well yesterday night? Did you enjoy the food? They don't talk about their future. Okay, let's assume you had no idea. Then you stumbled into a drama and this man is about to propose. Who should cry? From the last time I checked, when God made the woman, he took her by hand. That's why till tomorrow, till today, and forever, whenever a wedding is happening, you see the father of the bride holding her daughter and walking down the aisle. That was what happened in the Garden of Eden. God molded the woman and gave her a shape. Put elastic here. Put another one here. Put another one in her tummy. And another one where I don't want to mention, so that her husband will tell us about that one in the bedroom. And then another person that has an opportunity to look at that one is the doctors and the nurses. They will only watch, but they can never manipulate. 1 cm to 2, 2 to 8, 8 to 10, and the head of a baby comes out and it closes again. So God decorated her and made her beautiful, took her by hand, and they started walking down the aisle. Who were they going to meet? Adam. Where were they going to meet Adam? In the Garden of Eden. So I know God was telling the woman, I wonder what he will do when he will see you. He's about to propose to you. He's been waiting for you, but he doesn't know how you look like. They talked. So when God got there and handed the woman over to Adam, Adam lost it. A little colomenta. He didn't even remember to say thank you. So the one who was so excited in the Garden of Eden was Adam, not a woman. Bible says in Proverbs 18:22, he that findeth a wife findeth a good thing and obtaineth favor from the Lord. So who is the man finding? A woman. Who is the woman? A good thing. What is that good thing called? Favor. Biko nunu. Who should celebrate when you see favor? It is the man. What do you mean by he just proposed? What about, yeah, she just agreed? Which one should come? You see, this is the beginning of failure in marriage. When you give the man an impression that he's doing you a favor, rather than you being a decorated favor about to be launched into a man's house, into his life. Why are you crying? Who is beating you? Somebody said, she's crying for the man. She's saying, this one doesn't know he's about to carry a bundle of usobu, a bundle of trouble. So she's crying ahead of time, you know, and trying to tell the man, you're in danger. Another one said, tears of joy. Let the man shed the tears of joy. Another one said, she wasn't expecting it. That is why he should cry. And not you. Change this trend. Change this pattern. What do you mean? You called your friends. You gathered them. You had an idea. Then all of a sudden, he knelt. Why does he kneel down? That is to show you he's the one looking for you. When you're looking for your item, and then you find it. Pastor Nkem, if you find your gift, what should you do? You should be happy. Did you cry when you proposed to your wife? Eh? You didn't cry? Neither did she cry. Who was so excited? The man should be excited. I don't know about you, but my name is Favor. Kalagada. I am an embodiment of favor. Beautifully, wonderfully, specially, uniquely packaged by heaven. And so, fix yourself to the valuable items. You know, go back and fix yourself as one of the valuable items on that showcase. That's where you belong. So when you give him an impression from day one that he's doing you a favor, don't complain tomorrow. Because stop this trend. He just proposed. I see them do like this. I flip through. I don't watch it. Because it is wrong. Let the man be the one that will gather people and tell them, come and join me and celebrate. She just agreed for me to be her man. So that means I am about to be favored. Let me also leave this for you. You also hear people say, behind every successful man is a woman. Abi, he didn't say he's a wife. Oh, he didn't say he's a wife. So wives, don't take the credit. He says he's a woman. Every man wants peace. Every man wants joy. And so the tendency to go to that one that will give them that peace is 100%. It could be his mother. It could be his elder sister. It could be his younger sister. It could be the wife. It could even be anybody outside. As long as the man gets the drive he needs to make his day work, you see him going there. So you are special, the woman. But make sure you fit in well. And if you know who you are, there's no need. Somebody is coming to take a bundle of blessing. Let the man cry. I want to start seeing men cry. I want to start seeing men gather people to come and help them celebrate because Princess Chioma finally agreed. He that findeth, he's the one looking for. He just found you. He should be happy. No matter the situation, the man should be the one crying. I know there are cases where a lot of ladies assumed that the relationship was going to lead in a good marriage, and at the end of the day, it didn't lead to that. Maybe you've had disappointment. A man had disappointed you once or twice or thrice, and then all of a sudden, another one came, and before you could say, Jack, he's proposing. Even at that, that's a different man. You're not transferring the aggression of the experience you had 2 years ago with Nnamdi, and you're transferring it to Charles. Charles is a different person. So even at that, Charles is getting to know you. He's proposing to you. He wants to marry you. You have accepted. Charles should do the cry. Let's be calming down, okay?